We're recording here live. Can we get in the living room? Hello there, Kaz. Hi. How are you, Kaz? Good. Whoa. So he thinks he can play schmutball. Or so he thinks. Anyways.
Hey, warm that thing up.
I don't know what warms them up for me.
Warm the entire thing up.
Why?
Might as well have something.
Let's
do this.
Un momento, por favor. This is the one and only Antonio Trinidadish coming to you live from the kitchen. Time is 1:28 a.m. September 12th.
29.
It's 1:28 on Saturday, September 12th. 2020, you're all fired. So, and then there's that. Whoever, whatever that is. Hey, did y'all know I'm related to the devil? The devil's my cousin. And here he is presenting the devil himself. Voila! The microwave, she is done.
She's flatlined.
Yeah.
Beep, beep, beep.
Okay.
Not hot?
No, it's not. Try that again. Did you put the air on?
Yes.
Why?
It was hot in here.
Was the window not open?
It was, but then it got hot in here.
Well, why did you leave the window open?
I closed it because it was going to get... You don't leave the window open if you run the air conditioning.
No, you could have left the window open. It's cold enough outside. It would have cooled it off in here.
What?
You heard me. Ah! Oh.
You were fired.
Okay, now it's done. Come serve it up. Okay, wait. We'll put you back on a tripod. What the hell? Oh, okay. Nucleus. Relax. It's just a game. Relax.
Make sure that we protect our president. But the president kept continuing to say, I need to be in the Oval Office. The American people need the strength of a president being there. He said, I'm wondering if we're going back to Washington. He kept getting more and more angry. The president was vehement, adamant, aggravated, irritated. He was stomping mad. Anybody who was on the plane saw and heard the argument.
As a wartime president and being the commander-in-chief, you want to be in the center of the action.
The president said to us, you know, I'll be criticized for this. You guys don't realize that. He was kicked off because we had him out there basically running from the bad guys as he sort of saw it. But we continued to explain to him that it ultimately wasn't his call. But I think that made him even madder. And we came dangerously close to sort of a mini constitutional crisis here because we did have the president wanted.
You're going to watch the bed for a minute. I'm going to give you a call.
The military fought in the middle.
Hey.
Technically, I'm the commander of the aircraft, so it's my decision, you know, what that aircraft's going to do. But that's not really the case. I'm going to make sure the aircraft's safe, but the command authority is downstairs from the president and Andrew Carr. I just thought that he had to do his job this morning. I guess he had to do his job in Washington, D.C. if he himself was under significant attack. But it's like,
I just take that.
To implement without telling him that I was refusing to implement it. The president was very angry with me. And he held that
angry. I'm about to pop here.
It's 10 a.m. Apparently 20 minutes after takeoff. The president now was ruled. Angel turns away from Washington, D.C. Flying unscorted and unprotected. Air Force One's along. No support structure. Alone in the sky, no fighter escort. Now, at this point, we never traveled with fighter support at Air Force One. You never needed fighter support in the United States.